Hi, my name is Piper Rathgeb, and over this past semester, my group members and I have discussed and researched transgender visibility and discovered how to be better allies. For my deep dive vlog, I will be discussing how travel can affect transgender individuals and how America's security in airports can be distressing and non-inclusive for transgender people. Travel, while it can be annoying to all of us, is especially hard for transgender people. Aggressive body searches, the struggle to change or obtain identity documents, and the TSA check at the airport are all difficult issues for transgender people. According to the National Center for Transgender Equality, nearly 1 in 5 transgender travelers reported having been harassed or disrespected by airport security screeners or other airport workers. CNN Travel says trans people as a group face a higher incidence of harassment, frequent discrimination, and even violence without leaving their hometowns, much less venturing far beyond them. Within the trans community, trans women and trans women of color especially deal with these issues at an even higher rate. There needs to be a safer way of travel for transgender individuals. Only in 2010, under President Obama, did the U.S. State Department remove the requirement to provide proof of surgery in order to change one's gender marker on a passport. This kept Melissa Sklars, a transgender woman, from leaving the country for more than 20 years. It took her 3 attempts and 9 months after the policy change to secure a passport that matched her name and gender. The process of getting correct identity documents can be long and grueling for gender nonconforming individuals. Body searches and screenings while going through TSA checks in the airport can be triggering and traumatizing for transgender individuals. They are extremely intrusive. The Transportation Security Administration, or commonly called the TSA, under the United States Department of Homeland Security, overlooks security of transportation in and connected to the United States. While discussing one genderqueer individual's experience with TSA, Allison Hope, author of the CNN Travel article, Traveling as a Trans Person, It's Complicated, says scanners and pat-downs are often ill-suited to the bodies and sensitivities of passengers who are not cisgender. Jules, the genderqueer person, says a TSA agent grabbed their chest without warning or consent and mumbled about how they thought Jules was male but was wrong. They also were forced to take off their binder to avoid confusion. Dawn Ennis, a transgender woman, revealed that she was questioned by TSA about her vaginal dilators, a device trans women commonly use after gender affirmation surgery. According to the TSA page on the transgender passengers, you must inform the TSA officer if you have medically necessary liquids and medications, medical equipment, and or prosthetics, and separate them from other belongings before screening begins. If you need to resolve an alarm, you may request the bag be opened, inspected in private. As for the AIT screening process, the TSA says TSA's AIT units utilize software that relies on gender-specific algorithms and a generic physical outline of the human body that is identical for all passengers. When you enter the imaging portal, the TSA officer will press a button designating your gender as male or female based on the TSA officer's assessment of how you present. In the CNN article, Traveling as a Trans Person, It's Complicated, Hope says travel adds an exponential unknown to the equation, which can make everything from going through airport security, hailing a cab, renting an apartment, or engaging in an excursion a potential risk. Jules, the gender fluid person, also recalled a time when they were so terrified of their Airbnb host that they stacked bags against their door in hopes that it would block the host from entering at night, and had to ask to be let out of cab before their destination because they became so uncomfortable. United States Airlines, JetBlue, Delta, and other airlines have announced their inclusion of the non-binary gender identity to their plane tickets. There are advancements being made in AIT technology to implement a more gender-neutral algorithm to benefit transgender, non-binary, and other gender non-conforming travelers. In May 2022, TSA updated their screening procedures to better include these individuals through less invasive screening and reduce the number of pat-downs. TSA PreCheck has been updated to include an additional gender marker option to better serve gender nonconforming travelers. There are current attempts being made for travel to be safer and more inclusive to transgender individuals. However, the travel process right now can expose transgender travelers to bias and harassment, and even has the potential of unsafely outing individuals. Everyone has the right to be treated with respect while traveling, and the traveling process, especially screenings and pat downs, was not made with all individuals in mind. Thank you.